Testing 1 2 3. Testing 1 2 3.
Different from the other pushes.
got to do something, right? No, no, from here, look at them. And then they come up. Turn towards me. Towards me.
Oh, that's right, yeah.
Turn towards me, yeah. Cross over. Good. Right, good. Left palm. Palm, step forward. Right palm, step forward again. Double punch. No. Step forward and double punch. That means your right foot goes forward. Right foot goes forward. Kimbo. Okay? Left punch. Left punch. Yeah, this way. Left punch. No. Okay, yeah, okay. Excuse me. Okay? From here, punch. Come back. Parent close. Push. Okay, step back, open, close. Now you go at diagonal. Okay, brush knee towards me. Okay, go down to a break. Go forward, go back, right? And then you look, then you're facing towards the house. End up facing the house. Step forward, dip. The right foot steps forward. So open and close. Yeah, if you don't get the feet position, then your next moves are going to be off, and by that time, you're going to start moving around. So you have to see, if you notice what you're doing, you're going back and forth, now you're in this position. If you remember at the beginning, you go here, okay? One, two, three, here. Then you turn, going the other way, and then you go here. Okay, and then you do the open up, and then you're facing here again. So you go back and forth. All you got to remember is you're going back and forth, so you're now in this position again. Okay, facing here. You go back and forth, okay? So this time you end up here, but you're facing forward. This is the first time you're facing that direction. All the other directions is either in front of you or behind you. Open, close. You got the open closers here in front, and you got open closers behind you. Now you're going here. So you're going to your third direction with your... And am I getting too confusing for you?
No, it makes sense. Yeah.
I'm sorry. Okay. Yeah. Well, a lot of times I catch myself. I am just going...
It makes sense. Yeah. And I respect the fact that you go any further. And so...
Yeah, essentially, okay, and it's very important. Once you, it takes a long, long time. I'm not going to mince words. Until you really understand the angles are so important. They really, and you change your energy. See, like, basically, you know, Qigong is just getting your energy to flow. It's there already, but you're actually moving in different directions and everything, all right? But it's actually holistic health, basically, I guess you would say, overall. Okay, like someone once said, he's like taking a nice shower. Uh-huh. You know, Qigong is like taking a nice shower, all right? Doing Tai Chi is like, now you have a hose. That force is going, now you're putting the forces out in different directions. So, you know, but the shower is a great example. You have that overall good feeling. With Tai Chi, you're actually directing your energy. Okay, because right now, all you're doing, we talked about that last night. And I don't, it's up to you. What you're doing right now is just simple exercise. You're not really doing intention. And, okay, well, we're not talking about people like you, we're talking about people that have, like, you know, 30, 40 years, and they're still doing exercise. They're not doing intention anymore. You know, they've never done intention. And the intention, when I say intention, all right, what you do is using your mind to do all this, okay? See, right now, you're just doing physical moves. Learning to how to just move, but later on, see, like here, you have to direct. And
same time. You're pulling the shoulders and turning. Okay? It's all one movement. Okay? Yes. Oh, turn, keep turning. Yeah. See, it never stopped. Do you understand? It's like this. Okay? You're going here. Look at here. Even while I'm sitting down. Here. It's just continuous. All right? That's very important. That particular move is, well, all of them should be continuous. But the thing is this one is hard because you're going from one direction to another direction. So you have to have your feet, your waist, and your upper body all together. Just that alone is a lot of work. Okay? Good. Ah! You forgot. Here, switch. Keep forgetting that other hook. Get here. This one. Switch. Then come back. And then come back.
Okay, so this one's got to go all the way up above your head?
Yeah. Okay. I told you already how this is used, right?
Yeah.
Okay. So how do you use it?
It's like block.
No, but
there's
what's
a
this?
Block here too.
Yeah, this is a block and this is a block. Okay? So the thing is you're getting attacked high and low. Okay? You're blocking both of them. But the thing is so this can be what? A break?
That's a break too.
Okay? See like here? But at the same time, if the hands are not okay. If the hands are crossed, okay, then this becomes what? Then this becomes an attack to the chin, okay? Or it can be attack to the groin. And, okay, see here? And then this comes up. See, because the thing is here, okay, the move is not... If you're in a position that you, let's say, okay, you attack me, okay, with this right hand. There's a couple of ways of doing it. This, okay, can go, okay, don't leave your hand down, okay? This can grow to your groin.
Oh, okay.
This, okay, when you do this, see, this turns and comes down, right? This comes up here, okay, pops. Once you pop the head up, then you press.
Okay.
But the thing is, boom. It's a quick, so it's actually the whole center. Okay, you're attacking the whole center of the person. You're opening up his center. Remember, like in Wing Chun, they always talk about guarding your center?
Yeah.
Well, this is destroying the center.
Okay.
Very good. See, so you get you get that in between them. And the pressing. And see, you drop underneath the person, see? See, the thing is, you should feel like, getting compressed. When this hand goes up, this is compressed, and then you pull out, and then everything. Right?
I know. I'm trying to, it's weird, because I'm trying to memorize it, but then I don't even have to memorize it right.
Okay, relax for a second. What you want to do is... Just try to, just relax. Okay, see, it's just up and down. Go back up to your heart. Press out. Extend, really relax. And then, and you're like I said, you spin like a top. So you go around. Okay. Think of it that, think of it as, think of it as whole moon. So you go up, down, twist to the heart, earth. Okay, so basically you're only talking about three moves, although there's like seven, eight moves, think of it as only three. It says one, two, three, and four. Think of it that way. On your knees, you're really sinking because you're going for the waist. This is a waist push. This is not a chest push. It's a waist. Remember I told you? No, that's chest. This is waist. Waist is here. You want to press lower. I think I'm getting too technical today. Okay. See, that's what happens.
Is it a downward push or
no,
is it a forward push?
Forward push, but low to the waist. Look at the first one, okay, the other one that you did, you know, like what we did, this one is higher. This is, remember, to the ribs. This one that we're talking, that I'm talking about is down here. It's actually the waist level, or your belly. Okay, think of it this way. Belly button level, but you're actually hitting the two hips.
Okay,
you know, the two hips, you're pressing that way, and you're pressing them in. I don't want to get too much into it, but the thing is now you're pressing the body. Okay, when you actually do this, you're attacking the internal organs. Okay, once you have enough power and all that other shit. The thing is, when you do this waist push, it's no longer physical. You're actually jarring up the internal organs. Okay? If you were fighting. But we'll never use it for fighting because we've never practiced hard enough. But I'm just telling you that it has to be lower.
Okay.
Lower. Okay. If you look at the old lady, she does it really. She does this really little tiny one. And the other ones are different. You can actually tell. I mean, if you see her, you know, on the YouTube, you see her. She does it low. And, you know, and then she goes really fast in the next one. I think to make you not realize that she does it. This is a totally different one from the other of these. Okay. Excuse me. Double pushes. Those are a lot higher. A lot higher, you know, this level. This other one is low. You sink into it as you step in. See? When you step in, yeah, okay. Step in with your right and then your left. Yeah, there you go. See? That left really pushes it up. That's your momentum from your back foot. Go from there. Oh, okay. Well, you can go from the beginning. Okay, now you're starting to bend again. This should be out, and then the thing is, you go, look at you up, really feel everything stretching out. Down, stretch it out. Come up to the heart. This is really important, the heart. Press it out. And then the thing is, they don't bend. They don't bend until they get to here. This is here, and then it, see how I extend it? They don't really bend. What you're doing is you're crunching yourself up right here. Once you go here, you're just going like this. And you want to actually have it here. Okay, see how it press, then turn. No, see, you're bending a little too much. To here, okay? This hand, left hand covers, okay, to your wrist, to your right wrist. Okay? And then it just comes around. Here. See, because you put, look at, you pull the shoulder, here you pull the shoulder, and you're in position. But you're already over a quarter of the way. See, you don't do it right at the beginning. You go here, go, just continue. At, too early. Here. Okay. this way. See, it's here. Step forward, whether you're right foot.